Mr. Scott, would you repeat what you just told us?
About an hour ago, the bridge control started going crazy. Levers shifting by themselves, buttons being pushed, instrument readings changing.
And on my monitor screen, I could see Mitchell smiling each time it happened, as if the ship and crew were almost a toy for his amusement.
Mr. Sulu, if you want the mathematics of this, Mitchell's ability is increasing geometrically. That is like having a penny, doubling it every day. In a month, you'll be a millionaire.
In less time than that, he will have attained powers we can't understand and can't cope with. Soon, we'll be not only useless to him, but actually an annoyance.
There'll be no discussion of this with the crew. Thank you.
We'll never reach an Earth base with him aboard, Jim. You heard the mathematics of it. In a month, he'll have as much in common with us as we'd have with a ship full of white mice.
I need a recommendation, Spock, not vague warning.
Recommendation one. There's a planet a few light days away from here, Delta Vega. It has a lithium cracking station. We may be able to adapt some of its power packs to our engines.
And if we can't, we'll be trapped in orbit there. We haven't enough power to blast back out.
It is the only possible way to get Mitchell off this ship.
You mean strand Mitchell there? I won't do it. The station is fully automated. There's not a soul on the whole planet. Even the ore ships call only once every 20 years.
You have one other choice. Kill Mitchell while you still can.